course, this storm is going to make it difficult to travel on the roads or in the skies. News 8's Aly Myles spoke with folks prepping for the storm and some who've already been dealing with delays. Good evening, Aly.
And good evening, Megan. Check out these preparations. Check out this pile of dirt. This is more than twice my height, at least 11 feet tall. This is just some of what Portland Public Works is going to get on the main intersection in the next few minutes. And at 3 a.m., they're going to have more than 35 trucks on the roads trying to keep those roads safe. But they're not the only ones making preparations.
Just were, and his seven kids. This is the one that lives in Maine.
For hours, Marsha Hart and her husband have been traveling from airport after airport, dealing with delays.
We've been in the airport for about 10 hours because our flight from the Midwest was delayed coming in, so we didn't have a plane, so we got delayed from both ends of the storm.
The couple finally made it in, but not everyone will be so lucky. Multiple flights have been canceled coming into the jetport, and more are expected tomorrow. While the skies aren't looking too good for flyers, Dan Morin with the Maine Turnpike says they're doing everything they can to keep the roads safe for drivers.
We treated the roads before yesterday's storm, which was somewhat unexpected, and that residue is still on the road, and what that does is it helps the snow and the ice from sticking on the road, and at the first sign of any accumulation up and down any area of the turnpike, crews will be called out immediately to treat the roads.
But Morin says it's just as important for drivers to do their part to keep the roads safe.
So what we urge people to do is leave earlier, drive appropriate speeds, drive according to the conditions, leave enough distance between cars so you can stop appropriately, and most of all, be careful on the ramps and the interchanges. Those freeze up quicker, as well as the bridges, and that can cause some problems.
And for those dealing with delays or stuck inside, Hart says she's got the solution.
Lots of coffee and some good food.
Now, I spoke with workers at both Portland Public Works and the Maine Turnpike. Both said the most important thing to do is slow down. One of the plow drivers I spoke to said he can't even go fast. So the most important thing to do is make sure you give all cars a lot of room and make sure you stick below those speed limits. Reporting live in Portland, Aly Myles, News 8.